In summer 2012, 25-year-old David went camping with his friends. The goal was to spend a couple of nights near a lake and enjoy the surroundings. And they had a great time. But when David went back home, he discovered something odd. A round, red rash has formed on one of his legs. David was worried and so he went to see a doctor. The doctor looked at the strange rash and prescribed David antibiotics. Then everything seemed fine for a while and the rash vanished. After a couple of weeks, however, David woke up in the middle of the night from pain in his knees. The next days his body felt unbearably heavy and he slept much, often up to 16 hours a day. When he couldn't take it anymore, he went to see another doctor and soon it became clear. David suffered from Lyme disease. Lyme disease is a painful infection which has spread around the world in the last decades. Although Lyme disease can often be treated with antibiotics, little did David know that his story will not end for a year. My name is Kevin Steinig and today we will talk about Lyme disease. Each year, Lyme disease affects over 300,000 people in the United States and over 85,000 people in Europe. And Lyme disease can affect everyone, so it can affect you, me, but also celebrities like Justin Bieber or Avril Lavigne. Lyme disease is an infectious disease which is caused by a bacterium called Borrelia burgdorferi. We get this microorganism through the bite of a tick. When David went camping, he was bitten by a tick which has been infected with Borrelia burgdorferi. He then discovered a tiny tick and so it could feed on him for a couple of days. In that time, it released bacteria into his bloodstream through its saliva. If bacteria enter the body, the immune system would normally be activated and start to fight them off. However, both the tick and Borrelia burgdorferi produce substances to inhibit the immune system. So David only got a hint that he has been infected when a red ring formed on his leg. The ring is found in 70% of Lyme disease patients and is the best predictor for the disease. The bacteria then travel to different parts of the body where they multiply. David was very smart when he made an appointment with a doctor and started to take antibiotics. Antibiotics are a group of substances which actively destroy bacteria. Doxycycline, a frequently used antibiotic for example, blocks so-called ribosomes in bacteria. All cells contain ribosomes as they are important to assemble proteins. Doxycycline can bind to ribosomes and block them so that no proteins can be made anymore. And the catch here is that it only blocks ribosomes in bacteria, so only bacteria are attacked. A single dose of doxycycline administered within 72 hours of a tick bite reduces the risk of Borrelia burgdorferi infection by 87%. Unfortunately, David belonged to the remaining 13% and so his infection continued. Some bacteria migrated to the joints where they caused symptoms. Knees might become swollen and painful. At the same time, the infected person might get fever and a shooting headache as bacteria travel to the brain. The pain might go away but normally returns after a couple of weeks. If not being treated, Lyme disease can cause lasting damages. Lyme disease might cause partial facial paralysis, sleep disruption, or arthritis. The fatal thing about Lyme disease is that many of its symptoms overlap with other diseases and so it is often not recognized. Moreover, the standard tests for Lyme disease are not very precise. In David's case, the doctor correctly diagnosed him with Lyme disease and started treatments. He administered two different antibiotics for a couple of weeks to really destroy the remaining bacteria. After their therapy, David felt a lot better, but this alleviation didn't last very long. For the next couple of months, he still experienced fatigue and joint pain from time to time. This stage is known as post-Lyme disease, and it is well documented that some Lyme disease patients experience symptoms long after treatment. This part of the disease, however, and its treatment remains controversial in the scientific community and caused the so-called Lyme Wars. Sounds spectacular just means that scientists argue back and forth. The issue is that the bacterium is often not detected in post-Lyme disease. Some scientists argue that there might be some hidden reservoirs of the bacteria which might cause symptoms when they reactivate. Other scientists say that there might be an underlying autoimmune disorder and not an infection. But yeah, normally in post-Lyme disease we do not treat an infection anymore but just the symptoms. So if for example a patient has joint pain or depression, we treat these symptoms instead of an underlying possible infection. What is known more and more, however, is that Borrelia burgdorferi can have other detrimental effects on us. 15% of all untreated Lyme disease patients get symptoms which involve the brain. This doesn't only include headache, but also mental disorders. The bacterium can also contribute towards encephalopathy, which means that the brain gets damaged. Those changes can lead to an altered state of mind, meaning that the patients might become confused and do not behave like they normally do. Furthermore, the bacterium is also associated with Alzheimer's disease. We sometimes find the bacterium next to accumulations of amyloid beta, which is the main component of Alzheimer's disease. We already covered how we get Alzheimer's disease and how we also might be able to lower our risk to get it in this video here, so I can only suggest you to watch it afterwards. In the case of David, his symptoms were treated, and fortunately, the therapy worked after a while and he didn't experience any major symptoms ever since. The reason why I've decided to cover Lyme disease is that the disease is spreading and I want you to be aware. Since 1982, the cases of Lyme disease in the US have increased 25-fold. It is not only found in the US but also common in Central Europe and Sweden. An increase in cases have been reported in China, Japan and 80 other countries. So what can we do to avoid Lyme disease? First of all, we need to avoid being bitten by ticks. So be careful if you walk through bushy or grassy areas. Also wear long sleeve clothes when in tick habitat. You can additionally apply insect repellents and regularly check yourself and especially kids for ticks. Alright, check your kids for ticks is actually a really good slogan, wow. If you do find that you have been bitten and you find a red rash, go and see a doctor. He can give you antibiotics, which are highly effective in early stages of the disease. Then there is a chapter in history where we might have been able to eradicate Lyme disease. In 1998, a Lyme disease vaccine was approved by the FDA and is shown to be 76% effective while causing no severe side effects. The mechanism in this vaccine is actually quite unique. Vaccines normally provoke the production of antibodies, which make us immune against certain viruses or bacteria. So if we have been vaccinated and then become infected, our immune system can immediately destroy the threat and we do not become sick. In the case of Lyme disease vaccines, antibodies do not work in us, but in ticks. If a tick feeds on us, antibodies are transferred to the tick, which then start to destroy the bacteria. And this means that our vaccination actually kills bacteria in another organism. Unfortunately though, some critics in the 90s started to spread rumors that the vaccine is dangerous. The media then started to amplify these claims and the vaccine became unpopular. The sad thing is that more studies have shown that the vaccine is not dangerous, but the damage has already been done. So yeah, that's the reason why we still have the disease and why it's spreading. Thanks, anti-vaxxers. But there are new clinical trials being planned, one by Valneva and Pfizer and the other by Mass Biologics. And that could at least help to limit the spread of Lyme disease. And with that, I have two main questions to you. I know that I have a quite diverse audience, so have you ever had Lyme disease or do you know someone who has had Lyme disease? And also let me know what I should cover next. And with that, some standard YouTube stuff. Feel free to like this video if you enjoyed it, subscribe if you're new here, and hit the bell button, and with that, I'll see ya! If you want to know more why you might get Alzheimer's disease, click on this video here. Borrelia burgdorferi is scary, but there are also other brain parasites, which are found in over 2 billion brains. Click on this video if you want to know more.